The next competitor, ladies and gentlemen, is a well-kent face to us all, Jack Lee. Jack has been regarded as one of the world's leading pipers for over 40 years, and I have to say, rightly so. This is the 50th Glenfiddich Championship today, and Jack reckons he's played in about 50% of them. When he won the Glenfiddich for the third time in 2021, he was the oldest ever champion, and he is the only North American to have won the Glenfiddich Championship. He might be, in fact, if we talk about overseas-based players, he might be the only one. He embarked on a project over 30 years ago to record the majority of the world's bagpipe tunes, plus the entire Peebles Society collection, and he tells me that's almost complete. Wow, he doesn't cut the grass, that's for sure. Yeah, I thought you'd like that. Jack is a co-founder and pipe sergeant of the Simon Fraser University Pipe Band, and he has been for 47 years. And they are the most successful band from outside the United Kingdom. In fact, they've won the Grade 1 World Pipe Band Championship about six times. Jack will be competing today on a bagpipe and a pipe bag manufactured by his own company, Lee & Sons Bagpipes Limited. He lives in Surrey, British Columbia, with his wife Christine, who's here, and they have three sons, three daughters-in-law, and as Jack describes them, five amazing grandchildren. So there you are. He's got the sympathy vote right away. I love the grandchildren. The tune he's going to play is the Lament for the Earl of Antrim. Now, the Earls of Antrim are said to be descended from John MacDonald, Lord of the Isles. The tune was most likely in tribute to Ranald MacDonald, one of the earls who in 1643 was elevated to the title of Marquess by King Charles II. It's again one of these arrangements like they had in these days, because here's the punchline, you know, here's the payback. This award was based largely on Ranald MacDonald raising an army in service of the king, which he did in 1644 when he sent 1,600 men to assist the Marquess of Montrose in Scotland. So there's always that payback. That's happened in a lot of cases, happened with Donald Dhuil Mackay as well. The tune is recorded in the manuscript of Angus Mackay and Duncan Campbell. It's one of these tunes I find where the final phrase in the Urlar sets the sort of melodic theme and the pattern for all the successive variations. So the challenge I always found in it, and I think players find in general, is that you've got to try and subtly layer these variations, which are actually quite strongly linked thematically, to create contrast in pace and forward movement through the tune. It's got a beautiful plaintive air to it in the Urla, and here's Jack coming with his own bagpipes, drowning me out as he comes along, but we're delighted to see him. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jack Lee. Jack.